In today's video, I'm going to be running through my top 5 perks in 7 Days to Die. This list is ordered, with the last one being my favourite. I'll give a quick rundown of each perk and an explanation as to why it's on the list, but before we begin, I'd like to remind everyone that this is just my favourite perks for my playstyle. So let's keep it civil in the comments, but by all means let us know your favourite perks in 7 Days to Die. While you're down there, consider subscribing. I make tutorial and explanation videos for 7 Days to Die. But with all the formalities out of the way, let's get straight into my top 5 perks in 7 Days to Die for Alpha 19. At number 5 we have Lucky Looter. Lucky Looter is a perception perk with 5 ranks. At rank 1, you get a 5% boost to your looting. What that means is it increases your loot to game stage by 5%. If you're unsure what that means, check the description for a video about that. If you can't be arsed with that, the TLDR is that it makes better loot available to you quicker relative to how high your game stage is, meaning it lets you get better loot without increasing the level of enemies you fight. Rank 1 also gives a 10% boost to looting speed, which affects the time it takes to search a container, especially useful for things like cars and munition boxes. I won't go through every rank in this video, but the final rank, rank 5, is available at perception 7 and increases your loot boost from 5 to 25, which is extremely powerful. And it increases the looting speed bonus to 80%, which is a really nice convenience. The reason I like Lucky Looter is because of its relatively low investment into its attribute, requiring only 7 perception to access the final tier, and how much faster getting things like the Crucible or higher tier weapons is as a result of the 25% loot game stage bonus. This perk is always a good investment, but it's not the highest priority in my opinion. Moving on to number 4, we have Healing Factor. Healing Factor is a fortitude perk with 5 ranks. Rank 1 gives you a natural healing factor for 1 health per 90 seconds, and critical injuries heal 20% faster. If you're unaware, critical injuries is things like sprained legs and concussions. Self-healing doesn't work if you're out of health or water, by the way. At rank 5, which is available at a steep 10 fortitude, you get 1 health point every 6 seconds, which is extremely good, and it also heals your critical injuries twice as fast. I love this perk because in the early game healing items can be hard to come across and food is scarce. Healing Factor rank 1 is usually a top pick for my first 10 perks in any given game. I'd highly recommend every character have at least Healing Factor 1 to give you access to some health regeneration before you have access to cooked foods or an excess of medicine. Ultimately, however, this perk is still low on the list because 10 fortitude is a huge investment for a perk which in the late game can be replaced with good looting and recipes. It remains in my top 5 however because of its power for new players. If you or a friend is new to 7 Days to Die, Healing Factor at any level can be a literal lifesaver, especially if you're prone to panicking when you get injured. Halfway down at number 3 we have Sexual Tyrannosaurus. Sexual Tyrannosaurus is a must have for any character who uses melee weapons or intends to mine. It's extremely likely that you'll have to mine to build your horde base. This is a strength perk which has 4 ranks. At rank 1, you get an 8% reduction to stamina usage for melee weapons and tools, as well as a 15% reduction in stamina cost for power attacks. If you're new to 7 Days to Die and you weren't aware, you should pretty much be exclusively power attacking your enemies unless you're playing on a very low difficulty. At rank 2, you get a 15% stamina reduction to stamina usage again for melee weapons and tools, 30% reduction to stamina usage for power attacks, and a new effect is added which gives 10 stamina on killing blows. That means every time you kill an enemy with a melee weapon, you will get 10 stamina back, which allows you to fight for longer. At the 4th and final rank, which is available at 7 strength, you get a 25% reduction to stamina usage of melee weapons and tools, as well as a huge 50% stamina reduction for power attacks. The effect of the killing blow stamina is increased from 10 to 30. This means you can almost infinitely power attack with such a low stamina usage and stamina on kill. This perk is amazing, allowing you to mine much more without getting tired and reducing those occasions where you're standing in front of a zombie unable to attack. And it's also great if you use melee weapons during Horde Night, allowing you to keep swinging all night long. As if this wasn't enough, it only requires 7 strength to get as well, reaching maximum power with only 4 ranks. This perk is not just amazing for new players, but a necessity for any melee based build that intends to survive for long. Coming in close at number 2 we have the Better Barter perk. Better Barter is an intellect perk and it has 5 ranks. Rank 1 only gives a 5% discount to traders However, at rank 3 we have a much more interesting effect of giving a 15% discount, and apparently Trader Secret Stash shows better loot. This description wasn't enough for me, so I went into the game files. This is becoming a theme for me in 7 Days to Die. In the game files, I found that the Trader Secret Stash has a tier, just like loot. At rank 0, 1, and 2 of this perk, the trader is at tier 0 for their secret stash. At rank 3, the trader's stash tier is upgraded to tier 1. You will now have a chance to see electricals, vending machines, rare tools. Notable examples of items that are in the rare tools category is the crucible and the auger. You can also find melee weapons, higher level vehicle perks like the 4x4 accessories. You also gain access to something called stash only items low, which upon further investigation means auto turrets and shotgun turrets. At rank 5, which is available at intellect 10, you will get a 25% discount, as well as the stash showing the best loot, which is composed of all previously mentioned items at a higher frequency, as well as tier 3 guns, which means anything like auto shotguns and sniper rifles, as well as solar banks and cells. Interestingly, rank 5 has a loot group added called stash only items high, which adds solar cells and crucibles to the loot table again, essentially doubling the likelihood of solar cells and crucibles spawning in trader stashes. The discount you get from better barter is nice, but I only really care about the secret stash loot boost. The ability to buy a crucible can massively reduce the time it can take to get one from looting or getting advanced engineering 5 and crafting your own. Not to mention the easy access to high level weapons like rocket launchers and M60s, as well as an increased chance of getting rare schematics. This perk is a must have for anyone playing in the mid to late game who needs a crucible, auger, better weapons or armor, but is having bad luck with looting. Before we get into number 1, I just wanted to drop in and say that if you're enjoying the video, consider subscribing. I'm trying to hit 100 subs before the summer, and in my last video, you guys smashed that subscribe button so hard that you tripled my subscriber count with one single video, which is insane. So if you want to join that group and support me, stay up to date with all the new content as it comes out, hit the subscribe button. I try to upload every Wednesday and Saturday. Also, before we get to number 1, I want to add in an honourable mention. My honourable mention goes to Miner 69er. Miner 69er is my second favourite strength perk and would absolutely be at number 6 if this list was longer. At rank 1, you get a 10% boost to tool damage and a 30% boost to block damage. That's the one that affects how quickly you can mine. It also allows you to craft quality 2 tools, which is helpful. All the way down at rank 5, which you can get 7 strength. I really like the perks that can be maxed without going 100% into an attribute. Rank 5 gives you a 50% tool damage boost and a 150% bonus to block damage. As a side note, rank 4 allows you to craft quality 5 tools. Quality 6 tools can only be looted or purchased. This is me coming in again, I'm not even sure if you can actually buy level 6 tools. I think it might also be capped at 5. This perk is a must have for anyone playing single player, as you'll need raw resources at some point, and even if you're skipping pickaxes and axes, this perk will still affect chainsaws and augers. So, all the way at my top spot at number 1 for my top 5 perks in 7 Days to Die Alpha 19, anyone who's seen my other videos can probably see this coming. Grease Monkey. Grease Monkey is an intellect perk which has 5 ranks. Since this is the winner, I'm going to go through all 5 ranks, and they are fairly different, so it shouldn't be too bad. At rank 1, which requires 2 intellect, you unlock the ability to craft bicycle parts and craft them 33% cheaper than someone who uses just the schematics. It also allows wheel crafting, which you'll really want to get early. At rank 2, arguably the most important rank, which is available at intellect 4, you can craft mini bike parts, again without schematics and 33% cheaper. You also gain the ability to craft gas cans from oil shale, which is so useful, and craft quality 2 car batteries, which is a thing, it's not very helpful. Another important one, we have rank 3. Rank 3 is available at 6 intellect and gives you the ability to craft motorcycles, 33% cheaper without schematics, yada yada, as well as giving you the ability to craft oil. Oil is used in a lot of gun mods and traps. At rank 4, you can craft 4x4 trucks, quality 4 car batteries, and most importantly, you can craft more efficient stacks of gas, which use 20% less oil shale to craft, and also stack better in your inventory. At rank 5, available at intellect 10, you'll be able to craft gyrocopter parts and quality 5 car batteries. Grease Monkey is my number one go-to perk. In fact, I always start my games by completing the tutorial, getting 4 intellect, investing it into advanced engineering to get a forge quickly, then advanced engineering 2 to get the workbench, and then I go straight to Grease Monkey 2 to get minibike, usually around day 2. I have a video about that on this channel. Check the description if you're interested. I then go straight for the motorcycle, usually around day 8 or 9. Vehicles are an aspect of 7 Days to Die that people don't talk about enough. If you're someone who doesn't bother with vehicles, you're wasting so much time sprinting around. This is doubly true if you're like me and you use heavy armor. If there's one thing you should take away from this video, it's that getting a vehicle should be your top priority in 7 Days to Die. Then getting a gun, then building your horde base. So, with that, you've seen my top 5 perks for 7 Days to Die Alpha 19. I won't keep you around any longer, just consider subscribing if you got any value out of today's video, but with that, I'll see you in the next one.